This is the old Pico power station. I thought it was abandoned. It might be a trap. I'd better be careful. Now where am I supposed to go? There must be a clue or something. The origami figure was in the form of a butterfly. So, am I looking for a butterfly? What the hell am I supposed to do here? Electrical condensers. Going by the sound of them, they're still active. A butterfly on the door. That's where I need to get to. This shaft is the only way out of here. Matchbox might be useful. I should never have got into this pipe. It's suicide. Where's this pipe go? I've got a bad feeling. Glass. Broken glass. Sharp as a razor. Impossible to go back. I'm gonna have to crawl through it, slowly, so I don't tear up my arms. Stupid fucking pipe! And Sean is gonna die because of me! I've gotta get out of here. There's got to be a way out. A draft. There's a slight draft. If I could figure out where it's coming from, it could lead me to the exit. The match flame. It indicates where the fresh air comes from. All I have to do is follow the wind. Can't see a thing in here. Where are those matches? Keep it together, Ethan. Come on! Yeah. I will not give up. I'm in this all the way to the bitter end if it saves my son. The match flame. It indicates where the fresh air comes from. All I have to do is follow the wind. Whatever, I don't really have a choice. There's no other way out. To jump or not to jump. Fuck that. Don't even know where it leads. Could lead to hell for all I know. Right. I guess I don't really have any choice. better have a good look at each one of those condensers. If I choose the right route, I'll have a better chance of coming through this in one piece. A butterfly. There's a butterfly over there. That's where I should go. I better leave while I'm still alive. I'm not gonna save Sean by dying here. Got to concentrate. The slightest wrong move and I'll get an electric shock.
Thank you. Oh my God. He's unconscious. He's bleeding. Shit, what could have happened to him? Calm down, girl. There must be something I can do to help him. Ethan, can you hear me? Oh my God, what happened to him?
You've got a hell of a fever.
Are those burn marks on your chest? I'm gonna have to get your clothes off to disinfect those wounds. Burning up. He's running a fever. Arms look really bad. I need to disinfect your wounds. Okay. The first thing is to keep calm. I'm gonna give him first aid.
Doctor, but I'll do what I can.
Crap. It's disinfectant. Not terribly good for burns. Sorry. I'll go easier. Your wounds are disinfected.
Can't put on a bandage yet. Gotta treat the wounds first.
That should ease the pain. That's all I can do. How do you feel? Ethan?
He's unconscious. Now I'll just have to wait. And hope he wakes up.
How do you feel?
I've been better. Was I out for long?
About 3 hours.
Why the Guardian Angel Act? You don't even know me.
When I was a child, I was always the one who used to fix my brothers up when they'd been fighting with the other kids on the block. I suppose I like to play the guardian angel.
You said you were here because you're an insomniac?
I've been going through a bit of a tough patch the last few months. It's the kind of stuff you prefer to forget. I do what I can to live with it, but, it's not easy. You seem to lead a dangerous life.
It's not the one I chose.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't be asking you questions. I mean, after all, we hardly know each other. You have no reason to trust me.
Listen, I'm truly grateful for your help, but for your own sake, I think it's better if you don't ask any questions.
Maybe I could help you.
No one can help me. You've already done a lot, Madison.
Right. I'm gonna go. Take care.
I didn't do it. I swear I didn't do it. I've got nothing to do with that business. I never killed nobody.
Oh, no? Then why did you run away when they came to question you?
I already told you I forgot to report to my parole officer. I didn't want to go back to prison. When I saw the cops, I just bolted. I wasn't thinking straight.
We checked out his statement. He has an alibi for at least 3 of the murders.
Fuck, that bastard was a perfect fit. Shit!
Ash? Okay. Sean Moss's mother is here. She'd like to speak with you.
It was a few months back. The middle of the night. It was pouring down. Ethan came home completely drenched at about 3. I asked him where he'd been. He spoke about drowning the rain. He didn't make any sense. There was something. Something in his eyes. As if it wasn't really him. There may be no connection, but the next day there was that announcement about another victim of the origami killer.
Police Lieutenant Carter Blake, and this is Agent Norman Jaden of the FBI. According to our information, Ethan Mars is one of your patients. We'd like to ask you a few questions about him.
I'm sorry, that's impossible.
I beg your pardon?
I'm bound by an oath of secrecy. Under no circumstances may I discuss my patients.
My job is to find Sean Mars alive, and I don't give a damn about any bullshit oath.
It's your duty to inform the police if you suspect one of your patients, Doctor.
I'm sorry. I can't help you. And now I must ask you to leave.
You need to cooperate. For your own sake.
I know you don't want to protect a murderer. If you know anything, you must tell us, Doctor.
Are you threatening me?
I'm just giving you some free advice, Doc. I suggest you take it.
He's right. Legally, you gotta tell us what you know.
I am going to call the police and make a complaint about your behavior.
Doctor, you are really pushing my buttons. The only thing I'm interested in is saving that kid's life.
So, you're gonna be a good boy and tell me what I want to know, or I am really gonna lose my temper.
Doctor, a child's life is at stake.
Let
you go. May know something that could help us save him.
You have no right!
Come on, Doc. There's an easy way and a hard way. It's your fucking choice.
If you don't let go of this man immediately, I'll report you and you'll be off the case.
What the hell's the matter with you, Norman? What, you getting cold feet? You don't want to save Sean Mars anymore?
I want to save Sean Mars just as much as you do, but that doesn't give me all rights. So you're gonna stop this shit right now.
Ethan Mars has had psychological problems since his first son died. Feels responsible for his death. A sort of morbid neurosis. He is haunted by visions of drowning bodies. A few weeks ago, after one of our usual sessions, I found this on the floor. It must have fallen out of his pocket.
Ash, I want you to assign every available man to finding Ethan Mars. I want a man outside his place day and night. Notify all agencies to start looking for him. I want you to keep an eye on the train stations, the airports, the bus terminals. I want every cop in the city on his ass, so that if he moves, we know about it. Yes, Ethan Mars is the origami killer.